In February 2024, NASA's Time spacecraft, on a mission since 2001 to study the Earth's atmosphere, narrowly missed colliding with a dormant Russian satellite. The two crafts were just 30 feet apart, about the length of a school bus. NASA called the encounter shocking. Had the two assets collided, a storm of hypervelocity shrapnel would have spread hundreds of miles, tearing through everything in its path, endangering the lives of astronauts and wreaking havoc on the billions of dollars of technology humans rely on for daily life. This near hit is a chilling reminder that the rules of space have become far more complex. Since the days of the Apollo moon missions, the United States has enjoyed 70 years of dominance in space. We've come to depend on space-based technologies. These include everything from weather forecast to GPS-powered apps like Google Maps, and perhaps most importantly, the internet, which has become an essential part of modern life. But in many ways, the United States has begun to lag behind its competitors, risking serious consequences. In the past 5 years alone, China has launched more than 500 objects into space and has also built its own orbiting space station and remains the only country to have placed not just one, but two landers on the far side of the moon. China is not alone in its acceleration. The number of countries with at least one object in space has doubled since 2010. Today, more than 90 nations together possess over 13,000 satellites, and those are just the active ones. Governments are no longer driving the technological advances in space. Private companies are now leading the way. With so many assets in space, space traffic management has become a looming challenge that must be solved. No single international organization governs space flight safety or dispute resolution like the agencies that manage civil air traffic or international shipping. In fact, each country assigns its own orbital position before launch into low Earth orbit, and no international rules exist to resolve overlapping paths. This threat is compounded by the sheer amount of infrastructure already floating in space. Simply put, more stuff in space means more space junk, and more space junk means more chance for collision. Look no further than what happened when a small metal fragment, thinner than a human hair, hit a window on the International Space Station. If the station's windows weren't reinforced with silica, or the debris was just a bit bigger, it could have spelled disaster for the crew members' lives. Satellites are also essential to U.S. national security, enabling the United States to communicate with its military forces, gather intelligence, and even warn of a potential nuclear attack. Because the United States maintains more strategic assets in space than any other country, its space infrastructure is uniquely vulnerable. U.S. space assets are increasingly at risk from attacks by China, Russia, and other potential adversaries that could come from the ground, from the air, or from space itself. For instance, Russia is developing so-called direct ascent ASAT, or anti-satellite missiles, which would have the ability to destroy a satellite in space. Although current international treaties prohibit governments from placing nuclear weapons in space, U.S. adversaries have moved closer and closer to breaking international norms on Earth and in orbit. A lot is at stake. We must make space leadership a national priority and help set the agenda for international cooperation. Even potential adversaries will need to work together to ensure traffic safety in space. And the expertise and the perspective of the private sector will be critical to effective space traffic management. Our actions now will shape human activity in space for decades. Much like the high seas, space is beyond national jurisdiction. All countries must work together to maintain open access. The United States has long been a leader in space. It's time to make sure we don't fall behind.